Midori Ito of Japan is the first of the medal contenders to arrive at the ice hall, some 2 hours before she's scheduled to compete. When we come back, a look back at one of the most significant events in the history of U.S. figure skating. We are back inside the Olympic Ice Hall in Albertville, the ladies' free program underway tonight. Good evening once again, everybody. I'm Verne Lundquist. There exists a very real possibility tonight that two American women will be atop the podium during the medal ceremony. That has not happened for the United States in 32 years, since 1960 in Squaw Valley, when Carol Heiss and Barbara Ann Rolls finished first and third. 1 year later, the United States figure skating community was devastated by a tragedy of overwhelming dimension. The Olympic figure skating team sent to Squaw Valley in 1960 was one of America's best. Carol Heiss and David Jenkins both brought home the gold. As in most post-Olympic years, the champions retired. 1961 brought forth a generation of new faces, a little rough around the edges, but strong on potential. At the 1961 U.S. National Championships, four new champions were crowned. Champions like Maribel Owen and her sister Laurence, who would begin looking forward to the 1964 Olympics. On February 14th, the new team, coaches and family members, assembled at Kennedy Airport full of anticipation as they boarded the plane to Brussels, the first leg on their way to Prague in the World Championships. The sky was clear as the jet came into sight of the control tower and began a holding pattern over the sleepy town of Berg. But when they began the final approach, the landing gear retracted, the jet pulled up erratically, and the control tower lost contact. On Sabina Flight 548, there were no survivors.
You couldn't hear anything. No crying, no sounds. Everyone must have died instantly.
I got a phone call, and the first thing they said to me, did you hear about the plane crash?
My friend called me, and she was in tears. And then she finally kept saying, no, you don't understand, they're all dead.
It was just a total shock, and, you know, these were my friends. These were people I competed with.
Who were these talented unknown skaters who never had the chance to fulfill their promise? Rhody Lee Michelson had the raw talent of a Tonya Harding. Donnelly Carrier and Roger Campbell, second in ice dancing, were shy and stylish. Greg Kelly, so young and yet such a great natural jumper. Perhaps the most devastating loss, the Owen family. Laurence had the mark of a world champion, while Maribel Jr. paired up with Dudley Richards to display her talent. But it was their coach and mother, Maribel Owen, a 1932 Olympic bronze medalist, who inspired so many.
Her enthusiasm, her energy, her ability to give of herself to everyone, not just to me, but to all of the skaters that worked with her, she gave her total life to them.
Isla Ray and Ray Hadley and their mother perished, leaving their father behind. The loss was deeper than imagined.
It wasn't just one generation, it was like three generations. We missed the teaching ability to bring the next generation up.
And so in the memory of the skaters like Stephanie Westerfeld, who skated at the famous Broadmoor Arena, a permanent memorial reminds us of the loss from which it took 8 years to recover. By 1968, Peggy Fleming had blossomed into a champion, leading the American team back to the top. But a living tribute to those who died remains today in the form of a memorial fund, a fund which has helped every American skater here to get to these Olympics, so they might have the chance the others never did. Tonight, in the shadows cast by this year's Olympic torch, the three young American women who've been helped by that fund will represent their country in the Ladies Free Program.
Tonight, it will all come down to that 4-minute and 10-second program. A lot of work goes into creating that perfect Olympic program. And for Kristi Yamaguchi, that work started almost a year ago when she got together with her mother and her coach, and they began the very tedious task of picking that right piece of music.
Do you think this is too slow?
Not for an opening, I don't think so.
Might be all right for an opening if it then went in, say, you had something to build for.
I'm not sure if this sounds like me.
I'm not sure it does either. I think the most frustrating thing about finding music is just trying to find it. You can't make it. You can't make it come. And you have to wait and listen, and then try to get ideas. And then sometimes you can go and research it and look and try to find something that's that type. But half the time, it's just done just by, you know, almost hit or miss.
Hours later, they still hadn't come up with something that really excited them, but they had come up with a unique idea for Kristi. That was to stay with just one piece of music for the entire program.
I think if I use Malaguena, it would be best to use the whole thing. I mean, I like the idea of picking a thing and trying to stick with that whole thing.
Okay, rather than just picking three or four different kinds of music.
Right.
Hello? Yes, it's Sandra in.
Sandra is Sandra Bezik, Yamaguchi's choreographer who lives in Toronto. It is important that she can work with the music because it will be her job to make the music and the moves come together.
Because then what I'd like to do is just sort of edit a number of versions and then see what's most comfortable, because I think you could do just about anything with that music.
3 months have passed and the music for the Olympic program has been selected. It's a Spanish tune, Malaguena, reminiscent of the 1988 Olympics and the Battle of the Carmens between Debbie Thomas and Katarina Witt. The first phase is to edit the music down to its required length of 4 minutes and 10 seconds. This is done in a professional recording studio.
Basically, we went more with the piece of music. We liked it. We liked the orchestration of it. We liked something that made her look strong. And that was also crowd appealing.
That's better.
After months of searching, the final product, the edited music for her Olympic free program.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we'd like to pre-board Air Canada Flight 154 to Toronto. This is for passengers.
Kristi begins her journey to Toronto, where for five consecutive days, she will work with choreographer Sandra Bezik. Bezik has choreographed programs for Olympic champions Brian Boitano and Katarina Witt. Kristi begins the journey alone, but because this is the all-important Olympic program, coach Kristi Kasgard-Ness will come to Toronto at the end of the week to check on their progress.
Hi.
Hi, Sandra.
Kristi meets up with Sandra Bezik and moves in with her for the week. They will have 5 days to choreograph her free program, and the first steps will be mapped out tomorrow morning. The first thing Kristi and Sandra do is listen to the music. Then they'll try to get a feel for it. Both of them hear the edited version for the first time.
For a long program, for a competitive program, it's very much filling in the blanks. Kristi Kasgard set the jumps, and it's pretty basic how you do it. You do it so that they can be performed to their best. And then you fill in the blanks with art.
Sandra begins on the first half of the program, starting with the opening moves.
Not bad. This little flick is good. Sort of, yeah, that's cute. Yeah, your hair goes. We'll either be really good at it,
yeah,
or really bad.
After we work on the ice, I sometimes go through it in my mind and just so I don't forget all the steps I just learned and it stays fresh. The Olympics is like a once-in-a-lifetime thing, something that I've waited for all my life. That, you know, it's important, yet I don't want to get too hung up on it and think of it as a life-or-death situation.
Good morning, 9 minutes after 10, and another
day two. It will be important to get a lot done. Yesterday, they were just getting a feel for the program. Today, they start again at the beginning.
I've been doing it for profile, but it's wonderful from front view. I wonder if we should switch it to face the judges. There. Oh, I like this. And sharp. Sharp, that's it. We need something else there.
today I needed to get some real steps in there, even if they do end up changing. We needed to do concrete work that had some form and structure.
Less than half of the program is finished. Yamaguchi's coach, Kristi Kasgard-Ness, will be arriving tomorrow to check on their progress. It's a visit which Sandra Bezek is a little apprehensive about.
I'm looking forward to Kristi coming, but I'm hoping that it doesn't stop our work process, you know, by overanalyzing at this point. And Kristi Yamaguchi needs time for this all to become comfortable. So I'm hoping that Kristi Kasgard won't be too judgmental too quickly.
Coach Kristi Kasgard-Ness arrives bright and early at Sandra Bezek's house after a long trip from Edmonton.
Good to see you. Welcome.
Thank you. Hi. A quick hello, and they all head to the rink to show her what they've done with the program.
Well, why don't we do sort of like a walk first?
Oh, that's neat. I thought maybe you could give her some tips about stroking faster.
We talked about that. Yes, we did.
That was better. Just a little bit.
Yeah. Oh, good. That was a nice one. Did you like that?
I like that a lot.
It's the last day, and still, there's a lot to get accomplished.
We really need the program finished today, so I just told Sandra this morning that I would sit off the first hour and not get out on the ice and just let her finish the program.
If you can snap, you know, just with your focus more than anything, can keep the body fluid, yeah. A little bit more arm and snap. You're right. I like your timing better. Okay, but your shoulders look like I told you to do it.
So
before the silence, so you're there for the silence.
Kristi's next stop is Enid, Oklahoma, where costume designer Lauren Sheehan will create a one-of-a-kind costume to enhance their theme.
I think it's important to create the entire mood of the program, and figure skating, people come to watch it because, you know, it's supposed to be a beautiful sport, and the costumes are just part of it.
From concept to choreography. From the finishing touches to the hours of training. Tonight, it all comes down to 4 minutes and 10 seconds for Kristi in her quest for Olympic gold.
You will see the results of Kristi Yamaguchi's effort when she skates later on this evening. By virtue of a random draw, Kristi will be the first of the final six skaters to compete. She's followed by Nancy Kerrigan, then Surya Bonaly, Tanya Harding, Midori Ito, and Laetitia Hubert. They're backstage right now. They'll be on the ice when we come back to Albertville.
This is the moment, this is the day, this is the moment when I know I'm on my way. Every endeavor I have made ever is coming into play, it's here and now, today. This is the moment, this is the time, when the momentum and the moment are in rhyme. Give me this momentous moment. I'll gather up my past and make some sense at last. This is the moment when all I've done, all of the dreaming, scheming, and screaming becomes becomes one. This is the day. Just see it shine. When all I've lived for becomes mine.
The moment is indeed here for Kristi Yamaguchi, for Nancy Kerrigan, for Midori Ito. The seemingly endless hours of anticipation are over. The time for a decision is upon us. Good evening, everybody. I'm Verne Lundquist, along with Scott Hamilton. Six women remaining in the medal competition. Three Americans, two from France, one from Japan. Scott, they come from such diverse directions into this arena, not just in their personal backgrounds, but also their athletic ability.
Well, it's incredible. It's so hard to predict this event because everyone is so good at what they do. Kristi Yamaguchi, Nancy Kerrigan, great artistic skaters. They balance it with very good athletic ability. But right behind them are some incredible jumpers. You've got Tanya Harding, probably the best American jumper ever, and Midori Ito, probably the finest woman jumper in the history of the sport. Midori's been struggling in practice, but watch out. Her problems are not physical, they're mental. And if she can get over those in the warm-up or in the beginning of her program, she'll be a factor in this competition.
Kristi Yamaguchi during the warm-up, consistent, elegant. Mother and dad, Jim and Carol, are here, so is her sister, Lori. Has a brother, Brett, back home watching on television.
She's got to warm up quick. She's the first one after the warm-up, and you want to rest that last minute of the warm-up. She hit her triple salchow. That's her problem jump. But you can see the stress in her face just a little bit, more than any time we've seen her in practice.
Nancy Kerrigan from Massachusetts. Her mom and dad, Daniel and Brenda, of course, are here. So are her brothers, Michael and Mark. Second place.
And she's been warming up pretty well, too. Warming up slowly, doing a lot of doubles. But again, they've looked so relaxed in practice, and you can really see the Olympic pressure showing up on their faces.
The two-time European champion, 18-year-old Surya Bonaly from France. That's a brand new outfit. She'll be skating to a Spanish song and a rendition of A Matador and a Bull tonight.
The program is called An Act of Mercy. She's trying to improve her artistic skills. She's known more as a jumper. She's jumping well in this warm-up.
Because she missed a triple axel in the original program, she is sixth now. There is Tanya Harding with her coach, Dodie Teachman. I think, Scott, in a sense, Tanya is the wild card in all of this because she has nothing to lose.
Well, no, she's got this performance is really to kind of prove herself. I don't know if she's an outside shot for a medal, but you can tell the nerves are really showing up. A couple of the jumps she did early in the warm-up look stiff, tight. It doesn't look like she's into her legs.
The hopes of an entire nation came into the Olympics with Midori Ito. She has really been an odds-on favorite for the gold medal for 4 years, ever since she exploded on the scene in 1988. But she's had a tension-filled visit here.
And I was wondering if she'd show up for warm-up, and she's had a great warm-up. She hit triple-triple combination a little bit earlier. If she can get through this warm-up and go into her free program without feeling the stress that she's had, watch out. Nice triple axel.
Right now, let's go down to Tracy Wilson, who is with two-time gold medal winner and colleague Katarina Witt.
Katarina, you've been Olympic champion twice. What advice would you give to the next Olympic champion?
Well, you know, after you reach such a big goal and such a big dream of your life came true as an athlete, I think it's really important. First of all, you should enjoy it, you know, everything what comes after, just take it, you know, and just enjoy it. But I think you have to start setting new goals for your life and just knowing there's more and there's more in life, not just sports. And it's very important to go the same way how you did it in sports, to go for the goals and reach them.
Six young women remaining to compete. Three medals on the line. And they compete alone for 4 minutes. The 6 minutes of warm-up about completed. When we return, by order of a random draw, the first to skate will be 20-year-old Kristi Yamaguchi of the United States. In the Olympic Ice Hall in Albertville, where by virtue of the random draw, the first to skate will be the 20-year-old daughter of a Northern California dentist, Kristi Yamaguchi. She's in first place, and she now skates for the gold.
Great artistry, great choreography, and a big opening. Triple Lutz into triple toe loop. Triple Lutz, triple toe loop! Jump, a very difficult one. Triple flip. Nicely done. Kristi's consistency and concentration, unbelievable. The slow section, although choreographically beautiful, it's also the most difficult. Two jumps. If she gets past the second one, that's her gauntlet, and it's going to be tough to take that gold medal out of her hands. Hand down on the triple loop. And the next jump is the one that's always given her problems, the triple salchow, and she doubles it.
Skate next. She's in second. Surya Bonaly in third.
She's 3.5 minutes into her program. This triple Lutz is very important. She's left the door a little open, and she does a nice triple Lutz. Her last jump is a double axel. It's not a difficult one for her. Performance, but the door is slightly open.
Her father, Jim, making his first trip ever to Europe. Her older sister, Lori, watching as well.
Kristi, when you finished your program, you're standing out there on the ice. Did you think that that was enough to win the gold medal?
To tell you the truth, I really wasn't sure. I had one major mistake, and I left out one jump, so I was pleased with the rest of the program, but I wasn't sure.
When did you know you were the new Olympic champion?
After Midori skated it, we heard it was confirmed, and I still can't believe it right now.
What's going through your mind right now, Kristi?
Well, I'm glad this 2 weeks in Albertville went as well as it did. I can't believe how much all the hard work and the years have paid off for this moment.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
Kristi Yamaguchi of Fremont, California is the reigning queen of figure skating, winning the first gold medal by an American woman in 16 years. Jim Lampley standing by live in Albertville, France. He talked with Kristi about her amazing performance. Jim.
Hello, Bree. Ever since the days of Norway's fabulous Sonja Henie 60 years ago, the women's figure skating final has been the ultra-high marquee event of the Olympic Winter Games. The names resonate in history, from Henie through Tenley Albright, Carol Heiss, Dorothy Hamill, Katarina Witt, Peggy Fleming. Tonight, Kristi Yamaguchi has taken her place in that line of succession.
Coming into the free program, you know, I had nothing to lose. I wanted to go out there, go for everything, and, you know, I was pleased with the outcome.
Go for it, she did. From the opening moments, Kristi kept a breathless crowd in gold medal anticipation. If she had been stylish in the short program tonight, at first, she was immaculate.
I think the triple-triple combination, you know, just fed me some more energy and confidence. I think I maybe started to relax a little bit in the slow part, but wanted to finish with a strong ending.
The only glitch in Kristi's performance turned out to be relatively minor, touching the ice on a triple loop.
I don't know, it was one of my best jumps, and I think I just didn't quite go into as strong as I should have, and put the hand down.
The ultimate mystery of figure skating. How, under Olympic pressure, to recover instantaneously from potential disaster.
It actually wasn't too hard. I've done this program hundreds and hundreds of times in practice, so, you know, you train to make mistakes and recover for them quickly.
Quickly is how Yamaguchi has made her mark.
Has it sunk in yet that in the past 12 months you won the World Championship, the United States Championship, and the Olympic Championship?
Yes, it all seems to have happened so fast, and, you know, I never dreamed it would be this moment here already.
Of course, the pre-Olympic favorite, Midori Ito of Japan, rebounded from a shaky opening performance to win the silver medal, despite having fallen on her opening series. Ito's medal is a testament to her athletic fireworks. For the United States' Nancy Kerrigan, she can credit her bronze medal to a stylish blend of athletics and art. Kerrigan hit only three of five triple jumps, but her artistic scores helped push her to third place. And then, what a moment, 20-year-old Yamaguchi, as she stood atop the medal stand, receiving her gold medal from the president of the International Olympic Committee, Juan Antonio Samaranch. Bree, as you mentioned, the last American figure skating queen was Dorothy Hamill 16 years ago in Innsbruck. Tonight, before the start of the competition, Kristi Yamaguchi got a surprise visit backstage from Dorothy Hamill. Just the first of an evening of thrills for the young woman who was born with club feet, went through a series of operations to have them corrected, was lured into figure skating after having watched Hamill win her gold medal in Innsbruck.
Oh, part of her therapy. That was part of her therapy. All right, Jim, thank you so much. Good morning.
Unbelievable story. A lot of thrills in this country, too. Kristi's golden moment in Albertville is cause for celebration tonight in her hometown of Fremont up in Northern California. And that's where Action News reporter Patty Ecker is right now. She joins us live from what may be the happiest town in the whole state, Patty.
Well, I think you're right. It is the happiest place. Now, you can see the party is over, but this is where so many Fremont folks watch Kristi Yamaguchi's golden performance. In fact, one of the few people here to miss that television show was Kristi's own brother.
But it was a special night for Brett Yamaguchi, too. He's captain of his high school basketball team, and tonight was their final game and senior salute. Just hours after Kristi Yamaguchi thrilled her audience, her 17-year-old brother got his own standing ovation. His grandmother and aunt shared that moment. Brett got the news about Kristi's gold medal earlier at school. His grandmother heard it on the radio.
Nancy and I were sitting in the den, and when we heard it, we both screamed so loud, we woke up her five-year-old that was taking a nap.
Mrs. Doy and Brett said they'll watch Kristi skate after the basketball game, thanks to a VCR.
USA! USA!
Hundreds of their Fremont neighbors watched the broadcast together at a huge city party. There were Kristi Yamaguchi t-shirts and hats and a ton of civic pride.
Kristi's really impacted. She's put Fremont on the map.
It didn't matter that everyone knew the outcome. As Kristi jumped, they squealed. And when she stumbled, they groaned. And at the finale, some cried.
I felt so good about, you know, everybody's yelling, Kristi, Kristi, you know. And I thought, oh, I wish she, you know, she could be hearing all those things, you know.
Well, it's clean as a whistle inside here, but outside we're told the Fremont newspaper has begun to poster the city with signs that say, way to go, Kristi. Michael, Bree?
Patty, we were saying earlier tonight, you think it's a celebration tonight. Wait till she comes home. When will she be getting back?
Well, we're not exactly sure. She's going to Canada first, according to her. I talked to her grandma tonight, and her grandma said that Kristi's going to go to Canada, which is where she's been training for the last couple of years and living with her trainer, her coach. Her parents have decided to take a little vacation. They're going to Paris, and they're expected to be home Thursday or Friday. When the whole family comes together, even their grandma doesn't know.
Be a happy time when they do.
It sure will.
It's beautiful. These Olympic Games, maybe.
Mom. You know, moms play a big part in a skater's life, and this mom, for a number of reasons, is our étoile du jour. Nancy is a star, but it's Mom we want to put up on a platform. Legally blind, she watches Nancy close to a TV monitor. She can barely see it, but she sees it all right.
When we came here, I don't think we were expecting anything really other than just being here was a thrill. And then when on the original program she was second, then it was like, oh my gosh. And at that point, then I think we ended up changing what we wanted, and then I think it was like, yeah, I think we want a medal.
They wanted a medal and they got one together.
I feel happy, I feel excited, I feel proud, I feel just so many things. I'm everything, all in one ball. Okay. Like a Christmas package.
And Merry Christmas, Mom.
I love you.
When we come back here, it's a big Friday night show here. Arnold Schwarzenegger will check in to talk about terminating and speed skiing. He coaches one of the contenders. Arnold on late night. Rock and Roll Highlights continues to hold up the back end of the show because home video doesn't, but that's there as well. We come back here. Late night goes on the ice with Kristi Yamaguchi. A nice chat with our gold medalist as late night rolls on after this. Stay with us.
The 16th.
Okay, great news. Kristi won the gold medal.
That's Brett Yamaguchi earlier today up in Hayward, California. He couldn't be in Albertville because he's got a big game tonight.
And we wish you well tonight as captain of the basketball team as you go to play Irvington.
Playing Irvington tonight. Meantime, here in Albertville earlier tonight, we went down and chatted with his sister, the gold medalist. Kristi, welcome to Late Night.
Thank
Hold
you very
it up.
Much.
Let's look at it.
Here
Looks
it is.
Pretty good. Looks pretty good. Can you imagine how much work went into that? I mean, are you thinking about that now?
definitely everything's been so overwhelming since I stepped off the ice, but you know, the first thing I thought of was the years of hard work, the early mornings, everything that I've done up to this point has definitely been worth it.
I guess so. Let's talk about the skate a little bit. I might as well bring up the fall because everybody else has. What was going through your mind when you fell down?
Well, it was a bit of a surprise.
Why did you fall down?
Yeah, I don't know. I could kill myself for that, but it was the triple loop jump, and it's one of my better jumps. I think I relaxed a little bit going into it and didn't quite fight for it like I should have, and yeah, it cost me.
Was there a lot of tension in this area before you went on? I mean, was there, what was going
Definitely.
On back here?
There's always a lot of tension moments before you step onto the ice, and I think all of us were anxious to get out there and, you know, to put on our performances.
But you didn't think you could lose this, did you? Or did you, or do you think like that?
I was hoping to stay where I was after the original program. I didn't really think about medals once I was out there skating. I wanted to take one thing at a time, think of the program that I'm used to doing every day. So
I'm wondering how that works. I mean, how do you stay so consistent in skating? And you are. You're one of the most consistent skaters I've ever seen. How do you stay like that?
Well, I don't... Well, the consistency, I think, has to do a lot with the training. You know, Kristi Ness, my coach, has, you know, been amazing with that. She's taught me how to train, how to go through the program so it's easy for me, and, you know, under pressure, it will hold up.
Does this validate now the artistic beauty of your skating versus the jump and spins of everybody else? I mean, does this validate your style of skating?
Well, you know, each skater does have their own style. There was a lot of questions of, you know, artistic and athletic, which direction will it go, but, you know, I think everyone tonight put on a strong performance. You know, I tried to work on my technical aspect, and, you know, the other girls have definitely worked on the artistic side.
Diplomatic answer. Very good. How about Lillehammer? Going to be there? Can you think 2 years from now yet?
It's very hard to think 2 years from now. Right now, you know, anything's possible. I still feel I have another performance in me that could even be better than this one, so who knows?
Here's the how do you feel question that everybody hates so much. But how do you feel? How does this must feel great to be bringing home a gold medal?
It does. You know, coming out here, I just wanted to go out there and, you know, put on a show that I know I can do, and having the gold medal has just been the icing on the cake, and standing up there while they played the national anthem was incredible. So.
Congratulations.
Thanks,
Pat.
Thank
you for joining us.
Medal winners Kristi Yamaguchi and Nancy Kerrigan.
We are happy now to welcome Kristi Yamaguchi and Nancy Kerrigan, gold and bronze medal winners in ladies figure skating just a couple of hours ago, right? Just last night. Congratulations to both of you. Jim and I were wondering today when we found out that you were going to join us this afternoon, did you guys get any sleep last night? Your roommates here in the Olympic Village. Nancy, did you get any sleep?
It was late by the time all the interviews and the doping was done, so it was almost more this morning than last night. But finally we got to sleep.
What was it like for you two being roommates the night before the finals, being in the same... What did you talk about the next day's performance? Were you afraid to bring it up?
We were both excited about doing well in the original program and wanted to go in and do our best in the long and hopefully stay on that podium.
It's amazing. 1-2 going into the finals and rooming here. But Nancy, we're going to show you your performance from last night, and please feel free to jump in at any time and commentate about this performance.
Well, the music I had last year also is, this piece is from Born on the 4th of July by John Williams. And I like it just because it has a lot of feeling in it.
Mm-hmm.
This has been sometimes giving me a problem. This next jump, it's triple flip, and ended up being pretty good. I was real happy. That was supposed to be a triple-triple combination, and my toe slipped on the second one, just didn't complete it. But there's more.
It's a long program. You have to say to yourself, forget about it, right?
Move forward. Just go on with the next step and forget it and try and think of each thing one at a time. This piece is done by Miles Davis. It's called Siesta. A little bit more fun.
So you were able to put that out of your mind, though? I mean, what were you thinking about at this point?
Just the footwork, and then coming up the next jump's triple sow cow, and just keeping my feet under me and bending my knees.
Kristi had skated just prior to your performance. Were you aware of her marks?
I was on the ice when her marks were being read, but I
really have to.
I've learned, and it's happened before, where it's interrupted my thought, and I've learned since then, just by that experience, just to leave it alone and just concentrate on my own skating and not worry about, you know, what's going on around me.
I was interested, Jim, you and I were both there. I was interested to see that, Kristi, you were out there cheering Nancy on while she was performing. I don't remember seeing that.
Oh, yeah. After I skated, I definitely wanted to go out there and support my teammate all the way. I was so happy for her, and, you know, she's worked so hard for this, and we've been going through the same thing, and I was glad to be right there to support her and cheer her on. Yeah, you should have seen her coach when she landed that. I think he jumped pretty high.
It's the third time I landed it in a competition, so it's pretty exciting.
Wow.
What a place to do it.
Mm-hmm. Oops. I don't really know what happened there. It seemed like a good jump. It just fell out of line.
You're born on the 4th of July.
Yeah.
Music.
It's nice and sort of. It's just got a lot of feeling in it. If you've seen the movie and know the story, it's a pretty emotional piece.
The crowd loves this.
When you finished, what did you think?
I just kind of was a little bit disappointed because I felt good when I started, and then I think my knees, I got a little nervous in the middle of the program, and my knees stiffened up a little bit, but I was just kind of happy it was over, but kind of wanted to start over again and try it again at the same time.
Well, stay with us, Nancy. Kristi, you're next up. We're going to check out your performance from last night, the gold medal performance of Kristi Yamaguchi. Stay with us. We'll continue our conversation in just a moment. One, as we continue our conversation with Nancy Kerrigan and Kristi Yamaguchi. And Kristi, let's get right into your performance from last night and tell us what you think as we go through.
Okay.
Right off the start, you were the first competitor, in fact, of the top seeds to go. Did you like that position?
I did like the position going off first. I knew then I could concentrate on my program and not have to worry about what the other girls have done and, you know, how I was being compared. This is my hardest combination, the triple edge, triple toe, and it's only the second time I've landed in competition, and it was a relief to start the program off strong like that.
There was so much talk coming into the Olympics about the move of figure skating going in the direction of the athletic jumps, the quads and the triple axels, and yet both of you did your programs, won medals without those jumps. What do you think it says, Kristi, about the direction of figure skating?
Well, actually, you know, even though Nancy and I are more labeled as artistic skaters, we did have quite a bit of technical content, and that I was one of two competitors to land a triple-triple combination, so I think it was just whoever went out with a clean performance, or, you know, with the least amount of mistakes that, you know, was had the night.
But that's got to be encouraging, though, to see that that the artistry and that the expression is still valued.
Oh yeah, that's, you know, one of the things I love about figure skating is putting on a performance and not just going through the tricks, but having emotion and bringing the crowd in as well.
Kristi, when you were a little girl, you used to bring a Dorothy Hamill doll with you to the rink. You had a chance to talk to the last American Olympic champion.
Oops.
Trying to cover that up.
Thanks.
Good timing, Jim.
What was that encounter like for you with Dorothy?
Well, you know, part of the reason why I'm even in the sport is because of her. She was an inspiration to start up figure skating, and I met with her before I went out to compete, and, you know, she showed her support and, you know, really wished me well, and, you know, that was really neat coming from the Olympic champion and hoping that someday it could be the same for me, not knowing it would actually be this night, though. Oh, I was definitely relieved after that jump.
Was your confidence down getting back to the miss, to the fall? Was your confidence down after that?
You know, I felt a little slow in that one section, and, you know, I wanted to end the program strong, and I wanted to fight for it, so I think that's why the ending went so well.
So what's next? You guys take some time off, relax, what?
We'll have a few days off, and the World Championships is in another month, so we'll have to get back and start preparing for that.
I'm just curious. It seems to me at the Olympics, in the pairs, especially in the men's competition, last night all three of the medalists, when you throw in Midori Ito, all had falls. It seemed like there were more mishaps at these Olympics than in years past. Why?
I think maybe now people are just trying so much more, and the content in the program is much more demanding than it has been. Well, in the men's, not so much. In 88, they were phenomenal, but in the women's, I think maybe we're, you know, being put into a lot more demand than in the past.
Well, congratulations to you both. First time since 1960, two Americans on the podium at the same time. A lot of people really psyched back home.
Congratulations. Have a great couple of days off.
Thank you.
All right, coming up next, we're